welcome to this stateless Codecast. In this episode, we're going to install and configure and get to work with VS Code, the Ruby extension, RuboRoadPirate. I mean, Rubocop. So if you look on rubygems.org, Rubocop is a popular kind of enforcer of style guidelines. If you see here, it's a code style checker. This is the main page here where it provides information about installation and usage. So we're going to try to get this working. I don't have it on this Ruby version on this machine. So if I go, you can see this execute path is empty. Check Ruby, Rubocop, executable. So if we go in to a terminal, we can just, as noted here, gem install Rubocop. We'll pause and let this install. So the gem installation was successful. I should be able to, if I'm in a directory that has some Ruby in it. So this is our nerd dice directory. See what happens. Oh, we've got errors here. Cannot load such file, Rubocop performance. So we'll make sure that gem is installed. I have a .rubocop.yaml file in my home directory. If it's in your, if you have one in your project, it's going to default to what you've got in your project. And then if you've got, that was much faster. Got another error. Okay, we'll install Rubocop Rails. Try it again. All right, so we've got some errors here, so I need to go into my .rubocop.yaml file and fix it up. So we'll open that file. Just kind of do it from the terminal. There we go. So this is our .rubocop.yaml file. We'll bump the target Ruby version to 2.7. And then we'll start looking at some of these error messages. We had layout indent first argument. Now it's first argument indentation. /tab. Run that. Obsolete configuration, trailing blank lines, and rename trailing empty lines. Using Control Shift C whenever you're in the terminal, you use Control Shift C to copy, Control Shift V to paste. Is that the only one we've got? String conversion and interpolation. Yeah, that's it. Braces around hash parameters. It's just straight up been removed. Rid of that and try running it again. All right. So here's our output. We have some offenses, but it's working. This is what we want, and says 22 out of the 24 are auto-correctable, and we will make sure that it's working now on save in a So let's take a look at this notification. So we'll take a look at this, and so taking a look at this, this is just the warning text, the same that was printed in our terminal. So we're going to go in and just add these. We've got lints. Put these with the lint. Anything as comments, so we'll just leave them there. Now we'll go in and do the style ones. In a given project, I might overwrite this. For example, if I'm doing a standalone gem, I'm not going to require the Rails cops or anything like that. But we'll continue here. We've got some performance. Items. I missed one. One before we normalize our spacing. Here. This is a great commercial for Sublime Text, where it would be really easy to go in and do all this. I do have it installed, but I've already got VS Code open. And let's see what happens now if we run it, if we can get it warning free. So I'll go back to our gem spec here. See. should see problems here. So we're not getting errors, but we are getting the problems when we go and do this. So we'll stop right there, and I'll note in my nerd dice cast that we did that and fix some RuboCop violations in that series. So thanks for watching. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf. In this Codecast, we're going to configure RuboCop from RuboRoadPirate. I mean RuboCop. The main gem page, and then RuboCop. RuboCop.